I also have received a very serious question. Some sisters have performed Hajj, and this is not the first year, subhanAllah. When they return from Hajj, they decide to wear hijab. When they decide to wear hijab, their husbands refuse. They say, no, I do not allow you to wear hijab. So we receive the questions, Sheikh, I want to wear hijab, but my husband is refusing and said that Allah have commanded you to obey me. And this is really strange, because he only remembers that Allah has commanded the wife to obey her husband, and he totally forgot that Allah has commanded him and his wife to obey Allah the Almighty. In the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, no creature should be obeyed on the account of disobeying the Creator. It is as simple as that. لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. The Creator has commanded whatever, or has forbidden whatever. No one else has the right to twist or bend the rules and the commands of Allah the Almighty, or suspend them, or revoke them. Not even Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So if a wife says that, my husband says, if you want to stay married to me, then I don't want to see you praying. No, I don't want to stay married to you, because this is something contradicting what Allah the Almighty has commanded. I don't want you to fast, or I don't want you to pray, to wear hijab. If it is something that Allah the Almighty has commanded, then we don't have a choice. You don't give the ultimatum. I give you the ultimatum. If you do not allow me to do what Allah has commanded, I'm not interested in living with you. Generally speaking, each case, of course, should be handled separately, because obviously in the beginning, there are a lot of people in their cultures, a lot of Muslims, they were not aware that Allah the Almighty has commanded women to wear hijab in the Quran. They don't know that. Wallahi, I came across a lot of people sometimes while giving khutbah, whether in North America or in Europe, and some sister asked after the lecture, Sheikh, I didn't know that hijab is obligatory upon all Muslim women. One sister said that. I was under the impression that only the Arabic women have to wear hijab. I said, and what made you think so? She said, perhaps because it's hot in the desert. You know, for whatever reason. She's confused, she doesn't know. So now it is the duty to explain. Number one, that is something that Allah the Almighty has commanded all Muslim women to do. Ya ayyuha an-nabiyyu qul li azwajika, command your wives, wa banatika, and command your daughters, wa nisa'i al-mu'minina, and command the Muslim women. Yudnina 'alayhinna min jalabi bihinna dhalika adna an yu'rafna fala yu'zain. So if this is a God order, a divine command to all the Muslim women, then no man has any interference, should not have any interference in it, to say, I'm your husband, or I'm your dad, or I'm your mom, and you must obey me. Have you forgotten who commanded me to obey you? Look, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Your Lord have decreed that you should not worship other than him, and you should be dutiful to your parents. Surah Al-Isra. Then in Surah Al-Nisa, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship Allah alone and do not associate with him any in worship, and be good and kind to your parents. So I'm being dutiful to my parents because Allah the Almighty has commanded me to do so. But before this command, he commanded me to worship him alone. Worship. Worship in every form of obedience. Worship isn't limited to offering the prayers or fasting during Ramadan, or performing Hajj and those sort of rituals. Ibadah literally means atta'a, obedience. When you abstain from anything that Allah has forbidden, this is worship. He didn't do anything, he just abstained. That's worship. Similarly, when you make an effort to observe and fulfill any of the commandments of Allah the Almighty, that is called ibadah and worship as well.